Hey guys, my name is Ali and I'm a data analytics manager working in Oslo, Norway. Today I want to talk about how to structure your data analyst portfolio. This is something I get asked every now and then, so I thought why not make a video about it. Our main goal is to make sure that the portfolio is easy to understand and that whoever is reading it is learning about what you can do and your skill set versus spending a lot of time decoding your portfolio. I will use my own demonstration portfolio as an example. You can find the link in the description and we will talk through it as we go. So here you can see my example data analyst portfolio. Like I said, I will add the link to this in the description. Now let's just look at one of these projects. Now if I go into this sales management project, you will see that I have, you know, structured it in a way where I want to take the person who looks at this through a almost like a story or a journey for them to understand my skill set from the beginning to the end. So we can just scroll down and I'll talk you guys through some of these points. So the first thing I have, you know, I have a portfolio based on sales management. I have two other ones, which is one that looks into exercise data and one that looks into the Olympic Games data. Fairly easy data set to understand. And this doesn't necessarily have to do with this structure, but they are easy data to understand conceptually. The person who is looking at it doesn't really need to think that much about, you know, what is sales, what is exercise, what is the Olympic Games. They understand that. So the first thing I do, I have a couple pictures and it's almost like a teaser. It shows a little bit of the different parts of the portfolio. Then the first thing that I like to start with is I like to start with either a business problem, a business request, or something that kind of tells us what is it that we are trying to solve. I want the person who is looking at this to understand what was the purpose of this, what is the purpose of the analysis that we are going to walk through. So I've used user stories, which is a concept from agile development. You can look that up, but basically what we're doing, we're writing some user stories that make sure that we understand, you know, what is it that we're trying to solve, what is the acceptance criteria to know that we have solved it, what is the value that we're trying to deliver throughout this project. So that is the first thing I start with, and that puts the project into a context. It makes it clear what is it that we're trying to solve, and in this case it is a business request for some dashboards to solve some sales analysis. So I'm not going to read through these, but you can check them out. Check out the link in the description. The next thing I do is I move on to data cleansing and transformation. And that is because that is usually what the next part is. If you haven't fetched the data from the data source, then you need to do that first. But here, since we have the data, it's in a database, we're going to start looking into cleansing and transforming it. So that is the next step. And as you know, if we think from a story point of view, now we know what is it that we're trying to solve. Let's look at the technical aspect of how we're going to solve it and the data that we're going to use. So what I've done is I've written a couple notes, a couple sentences to explain where we are in the process, what are the different sources, and then it really goes into the different tables that are used. And what I've done is I've included the code, and I've also, where I've seen it useful, I've added some comments, which is also great to be able to explain a little bit of what is going on. And I have that in almost every single table. Let me turn this zoom on so I can zoom in for you guys. So you can see here, you know, I have some comments that, you know, says which table is it. I have some here if there is some logic. I've tried to explain that there. Different parts where I think it's useful to explain what exactly it is that I've done. I tried to add comments in the SQL code. So you can see all of this is SQL code. And here also I have some comments explaining the join. I'm explaining some of the logic so that it's not difficult to follow the different things I did and what was the purpose of doing those. Here we can see we have some joins, more SQL code. So I'm just showing how I created the different tables, which will then eventually become a data model. The reason I like to show the data model is I think that one thing is to show your front end result of your technical capabilities. This is showing the back end result of your technical capabilities, which is to show, you know, the result of the code that you have written in SQL. And it also makes it you know, you should be able to look at a data model and almost understand what is this going to be about. Now, it's a little bit blurry on this picture, but still, I'll try and explain to you guys. So now we have the calendar table, so we have time, we have the customer table, we have products, we have budget figures, and internet sales. So if I told you that I have a model with customers, products, a calendar, and I have figures on budgets and sales, you can kind of start to think, what is this going to be about? Which should be able to, you should be able to look at a data model and almost understand what it is that we're trying to solve. So that's why I want to show this, and I also want to show the backend result of all the different codes. And once again, if you think in terms of the process from the beginning, business problem, transformations, then we get a data model which reflects the transformations and what we were trying to solve with the business problem. That is kind of the structure that I like to follow. And you don't have to follow the exact same structure, of course not, but it's nice to add some comments, it's nice to explain and take that reader or whoever's looking at this through that story. Takes us down to the last part, which is the actual sales management dashboard in this case. And again, I've added sentence to explain, you know, where are we? We are more or less at the end. This is the finished sales management dashboard. I have pointed out that you can click this so that you can open it in case they might not notice. They might think it's just a picture. And I like to try and publish it so that it has like a dynamic touch and feel to it. It just makes it a little bit more alive. And then also, you know, from a presentation point of view, if you were to show it to someone in some sort of presentation, a live dashboard is of course a lot more impressive than just one that is a static picture. So I think that's a great way to kind of end it off. So let's go back to the top and just take a quick look at it. Once again, from the beginning, I have a couple of pictures as a teaser. I have some sort of business problem or a business request with the user stories to put it into context and communicate what it is that we're trying to solve. Then I start the technical journey with the data cleansing and transformations, which eventually will lead into a data model. And the data model is of course the underlying technical result, which will then be used to create expressions on top of that and then visualized in a dashboard as we have done here. Those are my tips on how you can structure your own data analyst portfolio. If you like this example, then check out one of these videos which will show you how to make your own data analyst portfolio.